In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Very warm welcome to the parish church of Walsingham today, as we gather together to give thanks to Almighty God for the life of his servant and priest Bryan, to pray for him and to commend his soul to Christ, and to pray for his family left here on earth to mourn. So we want to extend our sympathy and condolence to Father Bryan's family, those who are here with us in person and those who are watching this service today. And of course we want to assure you that as much as he was part of your family, so he was such a cherished and loved part of the church family here. And we are immensely grateful for all that he gave for Christ and his church. When it comes to the distribution of communion, the sacrament will be distributed in the central part of the nave. If you form up a line at the bottom of the chancel step, and the sacrament will be administered there. And there also will be another station on the aisle to my right, to your left. So please, if you're on that aisle, or indeed at the back of the church, make your way to receive the sacrament there. Those who receive the sacrament at their own church are very welcome to do so today. Or if you do not wish to receive the sacrament but wish to receive a blessing, please bring your service leaflet with you. The committal will follow this service in the churchyard, and then everyone is very warmly invited to the refreshments in the shrine refectory. In the face of death, the Church confidently proclaims that God has created each person for eternal life, and that Jesus, the Son of God, by his death and resurrection, has broken the chains of sin and death that bound humanity. And so, my brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Saying, Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain any more, for the former things have passed away. And he who was seated on the throne said, Behold, I am making all things new. Also he said, Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. And he said to me, It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give from the spring of the water of life without payment. The one who conquers will have his heritage, and I will be his God, and he will be my son. The word of the Lord.
Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died. More than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Please be seated.
Well, there's Ivan. When we found Father Parry's funeral instructions, we noticed that he had stipulated that his coffin should be as plain as possible. I thought, that's a nice touch, considering that Bryan Horace Parry could never have been described as plain. And then he put in those same instructions that I should preach. My immediate reaction was, oh dear, because I have some great stories about him that I can't possibly tell within these hallowed walls or before such God-fearing and holy people. But then I thought of all his homilies that I have sat through and listened to over the 50 or so years of our friendship, and he preached at my first Mass too, so I thought, right. I'm sure there will be a smile on his face to see so many of his friends and brother priests here today, especially as we gather on the day before just about the busiest week of the liturgical calendar. To all his family, to those here, to Melanie and her family in America, to his friends and all who are passing his mourning his passing, be assured of our love and prayers at this time. We give thanks too for kind and loving neighbours who have kept an eye on him and cared for him in so many ways beyond what anyone might have expected. To those who cared for him and those who visited him in Scarborough House. And I should add too, what a blessing it has been for Tad Parry to have the spiritual and sacramental care of Tad Harri right to the end. To be able to pray and converse in your native tongue was indeed a blessing for him. Which reminds me, as long as I have known him, Father Parry has had a variety of strange cars. One even had the engine in the back, in the boot. I think it was one of those Fiat Topolinos or something like that. I think here we were all much relieved when he gave up driving, because he was tending to go through roundabouts rather than round them. But I remember when he got one car with a tape cassette player. It was the height of innovation those days. Latest thing in technology. And he bought himself a boxed set of tapes called Teach Yourself Wenglish, which was just about the most hilarious thing that I'd ever heard. You see, you know that I have no Welsh, but Teach Yourself Wenglish didn't help either. But anyway, it helped the journeys of those days from Birmingham to here to pass quickly. Although it was sometimes a white knuckle ride as he was laughing so much. If you had visited him in St Mark's Hospital in London after his operation, you wouldn't have been the only one who thought, like me, is he going to survive this? The first chance I got to see him after he came round, all he could croak was, they won't let me have a cup of tea. And then there was the long recovery with all its trials and tears and tribulations. Luckily, he found a support group and friends who were undergoing the same challenges and setbacks in their recovery. But that didn't stop him sharing all the details of that recovery with anyone who'd listen. You know, Father Parry was never one to be reticent about his bodily functions. So, true to form, his very last words to me before he died were, "I need to pee." So, he did survive that operation. He retired early, came here to Walsingham with Ross, the dog, saw 5 administrators, 5 parish priests, and actually spent longer here than he did in all his stipendiary ministry in Birmingham. And of course, you know, the rest is history. It was as if the Almighty had said to him, "I am not finished with you yet." And you know, with his passing, we have lost another of that dwindling band of pilgrims who clearly remember Hope Patton. Soon, there will be none left at all. Father Parry was and remains a pilgrim. And he continued throughout his life and ministry to encourage so many others to join in the journey too. Since the news of his death started to circulate, many of those who met or knew him well will have reflected on how they first encountered him. Before ever I met that corporeal being that was Father Parry, it was the voice. The voice. The voice down the telephone instructing me in very precise and measured terms to be on the Coventry Road, that's a main road going in or out of Birmingham, outside a pub, at some ungodly early hour in the morning, in order to board a coach from the small Heath parishes for what was my first national pilgrimage. And I've never looked back. Coincidentally, that pub was called the Good Companions. And that is how it has been for me and for so many other people who've known him. Good Companions. And I love the etymology of that word from Latin and Old French. One who breaks bread with another. One who breaks bread with another. Father Parry kept a box of dozens and dozens of postcards, some from all over the world. And so many of them are thanks for his kindness and his hospitality, and mostly for good meals shared. In my Vicar's Weekly, I was reading the review of a book on priesthood recently, and it said, "A priest is a contradictory thing." I thought we'd even say that again. "Set apart, but radically available. The servant of his parishioners and the subordinate of his bishop. He upholds the teaching of the church whilst caring for the people whose lives are often at variance with the proclaimed ideal. He is at once familiar and alien. A pillar of the local community, a part of the global church, yet the bearer of a subversive message. A public man who carries within himself a world of private feeling and experience to which those outside the priesthood are rarely party." You see, Father Parry believed in his priesthood. He believed he was called to this task, anointed like Isaiah, to be and to bring good news. And he knew that this could only be done through being deeply united with Christ in love and in service. He had a wonderful gift with people of all sorts, types and conditions, and a joyfulness. Above all, he believed that the Eucharist, which he had celebrated so many times, was the source and summit of the whole Christian life. So today we give thanks to God for his long and dedicated service, and give thanks to God for the many blessings that we and countless others before us have received through his prayers and his ministry. A member of this congregation mentioned to me the other day how, in the most recent times, Father Parry looked more and more like the pictures of the Curé d'Ars, in his old age, of course. There is, it's a place that we went to on pilgrimage more than on a number of occasions. And there's a wonderful statue in Ars showing a young boy who's been sent out along the road to look out for the new parish priest who was arriving. And the words are recorded of the saintly Curé d'Ars to the boy: "You have shown me the way to Ars. Now I will show you the way to heaven. Bryan Horace, our friend, priest, uncle, relation, and fellow pilgrim, lived his life showing us the way to heaven. It is with sincere love and profound thankfulness that we return him to the Lord in the certain hope that he will raise him up on the last day.
My brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father where he intercedes for us. Confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
God of mercy, Lord of life, you made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for the life of Father Bryan, for the grace and mercy he received from you, for all that was good in his life, and for the memories we treasure today. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
You promised eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good your servant and priest, Bryan, as we also remember. Bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgotten and death is no more. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Lord, in mercy on all of Father Bryan's friends and family, and all who are mourning his death, give them patient faith in times of darkness. Strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Grant that all members of your church may so pass their days in holiness of life, that they may be prepared, when you call them, to meet you and enter into that rest which you have prepared for those who love you, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us now entrust Father Bryan to the prayers of Our Lady, patron of all priests, as we say,
listen to our prayers, Lord, we humbly beg your mercy, that the soul of your servant and priest Bryan, whom you've called from this life, may be brought by you to a place of peace and light, and so be enabled to share the life of all your saints, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Amen.
Thank you.
Lord's resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. For faithful and tiny and full tranquil unity, vela cam verbi veretti deviant per avvolti, gada mai and vlaina, avvolui vendigait mandi, abendi gaidea joseph every day frion, gada apostolion athetheron gogenethis, gada sanseion, santenion, at hort sant, am I in with thee, I will back seven, gerth and ac agam othini, gerth of rob. Byddyd i'r agedd hwn sy'n ei cymodi ni a thi, ddod a heddwch ac iaith a bwriaeth i'r holl ffyd. Nedfa dy eglwys byrerin ar y ddea, a chadarnhau mewn ffydd a chariad, yn hyd a thwas ein Pab Francis, a'n hesgol nôl profet sy'n gresennol, a'r holl ysgolion o'r ffeiriad a holl bobl. Bydd gyda ni dy deulu yma a derbyn ein addoliad, tostyniad a danwyr wrth dy holl blant a rhastad a pob man, ac uno a hwyl a thi dy hi. Cofia dy was a offeiriad Bryan, a elwaith data ti o'r byd hwn. Dyro iddo ac antai wedi ei uno trwy feddwl ar marwolaeth y fan. Ddod yn un hefyd a'i at y brodiad, pan fi ef yn cyfodi y meirw yn y cnawd o'r ddea, a newid ein coffwal ni fod yn unffydd a'i gorff gofynedus ef. Derbyn i'r deirnas ein brodyr a chwiorydd a ffanol sydd wedi ymadael ar byd hwn under ras. Yno y gobeithio ninnau fwy gyda hwy a mwynhau'r cyflawnder o'r ogoniad yn ddibaid, pan fyddi'n sychu o deirbyn o ddiwrth yn llygaid, o blegyd fe'n gwelwn di ein diw fel rwyt, a byddwn yn gyfferyn i ti trwy'r wrtsoedd, a chlofoi di yn di ferfyn, trwy Grys ein cadlwyd, y rwyt trwy ddom o'i pob dagon i'r byd. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, through our merciful. Eternal rest grant unto him who ordered, let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, through you are merciful.
Thank you. Christ the Lord.
Come to know your love and your truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.